Good morning students, welcome to you all. 12th standard commerce. In this video we are going to discuss unit 10 company law and secretarial practice, chapter 27 company management, topic qualification of director and disqualification of director and how to remove directors. So three chapter today we are going to discuss. What are the qualification of director? What is the qualification required to be a director? So as regards to the qualification of directors, there is no direct provision in the Companies Act 2013. So in the Companies Act 2013, there is not any direct provision is given. So in general, a director shall possess appropriate skills, experience and knowledge in one or more fields of finance, law, management, sales, marketing, administration, research, corporate governance, technical operation or other disciplines related to the company's business. So in to be a director mean they need a appropriate skill to be a director. So according to different provisions relating to the directors, the following qualification may be mentioned. So that means he have one or more skills, more experience in different categories. So what is that? Management, sales, fields, finance, law, corporate governance, technical operation, so other disciplines. Okay, so if having special skills, then he can be a director. So what are the qualifications mentioned here? Let's see. First one, a director must be a person of sound mind. So he should be sound mind person, not a unsound mind person. Then second point, a director must hold the required qualification if the articles of association provide such. That means in the articles of association mentioned, a director must hold the required qualification. Third point, a director must be an individual. So a director should be a solvent person. Then last point, a director should not be convicted by the court of any offense, etc. Next one, disqualification of a director. So the Companies Act 2013 section 164 has mentioned in the disqualification as mentioned below. So the Companies Act 2013 section 164 says the disqualification of a director. So first point, a person shall not be capable of being appointed director of a company if the director is of unsound mind. So unsound mind means he cannot be act as a normal person. So he is considered as a unsound mind person. So he cannot appointed for directors. Then second point, here an underchanged insolvent person cannot consider as a director. Then has been convicted by a court for any offense involving moral turpitude and sentence in respect thereof to imprisonment for not less than 6 months. So for not less than 6 months undergone with the punishment in the court, so offense is convicted, he cannot appoint as a director. He is a disqualified director. The next one, he has not paid any call in respect of shares of the company held by him, so whether alone or jointly with others. So if you hold the shares of the company jointly or alone, then he is not paid the call money, means he cannot be a director. So he is become a disqualified director of the company. Then fifth point, he has been convicted of the offense dealing with related parties transactions under the section 188. That means the Companies Act 2013 section 203 says about then particular person is not qualified director, means then he is not eligible to director. Okay, then if the section 188 says that about conviction of the against act, means he cannot be appointed as a director. Okay, so next point, he has not got the director identification number. If the director is not having director identification number, means he cannot be a director. So disqualification, so important disqualification. So every data has a director identification number. If don't have the identification number, that person not eligible for a director. Next topic, removal of director. So a director of company can be removed from his office before the expiry of his term by the shareholders, by the central government, and by the company law board. Okay, so when and by whom directors is, what are the characters, sorry, when or when the directors are removed from the post, from the post of director, can be removed by the shareholder, central government, and a company law board. So removal of directors is different from the different stages. First one, a director can be removed from his office in any of the following three ways. First one, when removal by shareholders, 169. So removal of director is different from the retirement of director. So the term from the direction is ex director is the expired, he is retiring from the post. So when we think removal of director before expiry his term, he is removed from the post of director. So first one, removal by shareholders. So a company, whether public company or private company, may by giving a special notice and passing an special ordinary resolution, so remove a director before expiry of his period of office without the proof of mismanagement, breach of trust, misfeasance or other misconduct on the part of the director. So a company, may be a public company or private company, may give a special notice and passing the ordinary resolution, removal of director can be done by the board. So the director done a mismanagement or misconduct with the directors or any part of act as misconduct, everything, no need to prove, he removed by the shareholder. Conducting meeting itself, the directors removed by the shareholder. So if the shareholders feel that the policies pursued by the director are not appropriate, so the director can be removed. So the shareholders can do so, passing an ordinary resolution in the general meeting. So the shareholder feels that the policies pursued by the director are not appropriate, then the director can be removed. Okay, so we are already discussed different types of director, the executive director, non-executive director. Okay, so executive director means manage the company. Non-executive director means they look after the policy making, planning, strategy, he will look after. So the director role play according to their role. So if he is doing any mismanagement or applying policy on any mistake, means director removed by the shareholders. Next point, removal by the central government. So the central government has been empowered to remove the managerial personnel from the office on the recommendation of the company law board under the following circumstances. So the company law board recommended a central government. In that situation, the central government removed the director. So what are the situation? First one, when a person consent in the conduct and management of the affairs of the company, has been guilty of fraud, misfeasance, persistent negligence in carrying out of these obligations. If he is doing duties mismanagement as a director, he is not playing a role, means the director is removed by the central government. Second point, but the business of company has not been conducted and managed by such person in accordance with sound business principles or prudent commercial practices. Third point, where the business of company has been conducted and managed by such person in manner which is likely cause the injury or damage or interest of the trade industry of the business. And fourth point, where the business of the company has been conducted and managed such person with the intent to defraud its creditors, members or any other person. The next point, removal by the company law board. So if application has been made to the company law board against the operation and mismanagement of the company affairs by a director. So the company law board may order the termination of the director's tenure or set aside any agreement that has been entered into between the company and the director. Such order can affect the removal director from his office. So removal of directors. So we discuss removal of directors. So a director of company can remove by from his office before the expiry of time. By the shareholders, by the central government, and by the company law. Okay, I hope you all understood this topic. We'll see the next section. Thank you, students.